This case study was inspired by a post on a forum. Let's see what we can learn here. We are starting off with a cylinder with a tapered end. The objective here is to create a rich feature and create a circular pattern with it. The user started off with using a sweep. Let's do the same and see what potential problems we face. I have prepared a profile sketch here, which consists of a horizontal line and two vertical lines. I have purposely made a ridge thicker than what was shown in the forum. This is so that we can have a good look at the geometry and compare between the different methods. The circumference of the cylinder would serve to close off the profile. For the path, I am going to use one of the primary planes to create a split line. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select these two faces to split. For a splitting tool, click on the select box and select the right plane in this case. Go to Create, Sweep. Select the profile. For path, click on the select box. Select the first segment of the path. Hold down Ctrl to select the next segment. Set the operation to join. To make the end face horizontal, we need to set the orientation to parallel. This will ensure that the end face is parallel to the sweep profile. So immediately, we see a problem here. The sweep does not appear to conform to the conical face. Starting from this edge, as we move up the conical face, the radius decreases. However, the sweep profile is based on this sketch, where one of its edges has a maximum radius. Since the sweep profile is constant all along the path, as we move up the conical face, it gradually peels away from the face. One way to resolve this is to simply control select these two faces. And press Delete. Fusion intelligently analyzes the surrounding geometry and hues it up in a way that makes the most sense. Go to Create, Circular Pattern. At this point, some of us might be concerned whether the Delete Face feature can be patterned. Let's find out. For Type, select Features, and select the sweep and delete face features from the timeline. We can select any circular edge for the axis. For the compute option, let's try optimized for a start. This fails. Let's repeat the process and try identical. So this works. And the delete face feature has been patterned. The adjust compute option also works in this case. If you are not comfortable with deleting faces, you always have the option of replacing the curved edge of the profile with a straight line and bringing it towards the center to ensure overlap with the existing body. Yet another method you can try is to sketch the profile on the top instead. Since the radius is at a minimum at the top, as the sweep progresses down the path, the profile will always overlap with the body. There is no need to delete faces in this case. At this point, I want to bring us back to the beginning and re-evaluate our design intent. Before we start, we really should be asking ourselves whether we need a flat face here and here. If not, there is a much simpler way. For this, I have prepared a sketch on the front plane. This is just a simple rectangle which defines how the feature would look like from the front. Start the Extrude command with this profile. For extend type, choose tool object and select the cylindrical face. We need to take reference from the conical face as well. To do that, we need to set the extend option to adjacent faces. Set the operation to join. Throughout this whole process, make sure to not drag on the arrow, as that would change the extent type back to distance. Instead, adjust the offset. We have created an extrude by leveraging on both the cylindrical and conical faces. We can verify that this is indeed a curved edge by clicking on it. This gives us a radius readout at the bottom right-hand corner. In this case, the optimized and the identical options would work in patterning this. The following are a few methods that might not give us a result that we need, but are definitely interesting to think about. Let's use a previous sketch to create a split face. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select these faces to split. For a splitting tool, click on the select box and select the sketch. Let's perform an offset face on these split faces. Go to Modify, Offset Face. Select the faces and adjust the distance. The offset face command offsets the faces in a way that is normal at all points to the original faces. This has resulted in these awkward looking faces. So the offset face command is probably not appropriate here. What about a revolve? We have a profile sketch here that represents the cross-section of the ridge from the side. Go to Create, Revolve. Select the profile and the axis. Adjust the angle. This doesn't look quite the same as the previous methods. Due to the nature of revolving, this has resulted in these side walls at an angle to each other. In the previous methods, the side walls were parallel to each other. So do keep this in mind when using a revolve. If we need the faces to be flat, we can also consider using the rib feature. This is not the most elegant of methods, but it is worth thinking about. The rib feature needs walls to constrain it. I'm going to extrude these two sketch circles to serve as walls. These extrudes would have to be joined to the main body for this to work. For the sketch, you will simply sketch a line that represents the outside edge of the ridge. A close contour is not required. Go to Create, Rib. Select the sketch line as a profile. Adjust the thickness. For depth options, set it to 2 next. As you adjust the thickness, the rib feature would find the closest face to terminate against. This prevents the gaps that we saw in the very first example. Once the rib is complete, you can select these faces and perform extruder cuts.